right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Quinton Hennigh. He is a technical advisor and director of Eskay Mining. And Quinton, it's good to have you along. How are you?
Pleasure to be here, Steve. Very good. Thanks.
Yeah. So you got some news out today talking about an area that you're going to be exploring very soon with the drills. Before we get to that, maybe just give everyone a bit of an overview of the project in general.
Yeah, certainly. Look, Eskay Mining holds 100% interest in the consolidated Eskay property, which is really an adjacent and extension of the Eskay Creek deposit. Many people know about Eskay Creek. Belongs to Skeena now, but it was a mine operated by Homestake and then Barrick in the late 1990s up through the early 2000s. Produced a lot of gold, produced over 3 million ounces, very high grade, about 1.5 ounce per ton head grade over life of mine. And then it also had a large component of silver, about 2.2 kilograms of silver per ton. So absolutely exceptional mine. Skeena is now developing the lower grade, still high grade, but lower grade part of that system. They're working towards a feasibility study as we speak. We've got basically the rest of the district. Okay, Eskay Mining holds about 85% of the prospective ground for these precious metal rich VMS systems. And we think we have basically the rest of this camp.
Okay, so you're doing a drill program this year, about 30,000 meters, and you've done about 12 so far. So the next stage of this is moving on to an area known as Scarlet Ridge. So tell me a little bit about this particular area and what this drill program is going to do.
Certainly. Look, Scarlet Ridge was discovered late last season. It was discovered right before the heavy snow set in September. So the guys got a little bit of a peek at it, but didn't get enough work done to establish drill targets at that time. So the plan this year was to hit the ground running. They've developed some really good field teams that came in and examined these areas at Scarlet Ridge and now Scarlet Valley and the Scarlet Knob target, which they just discovered. And they've developed drill targets very quickly. So the plan is to start testing this area with a drill. In fact, they spotted the first hole about 3 days ago. And as you see in the news release this morning, you can see the wonderful photographs of heavily sulfidized volcanic rocks that looks like VMS style mineralization. So we're already seeing good signs there. I'm very optimistic because we have a lot of season to work with that we can get some meaningful holes into these targets and really start to suss out what this new VMS extension, a really new discovery, I'll say, on the property means.
Yeah, and we should sort of let everyone know that these areas that you're talking about, and these targets, they go on for, they're named differently, but they go on for quite some time, about over 5 kilometers, correct?
They do. If you look at Scarlet Ridge, which is the first discovery they made of the VMS, and then you hop down to Scarlet Valley, and then Scarlet Knob, and then down to Tarn Lake, really it's almost 8.5 kilometers. And it's along a continuous belt. You can see in geophysics, it's expressed very clearly as a one continuous belt. And although it's on the eastern anticline, it is in the same position. Okay, the deposits that we see here are in the same position as the Eskay Creek system, which is at the north end of the Eskay anticline, immediately to the west. So we see a lot of similarities in the geology between these two. We also see similarities to the TVGF area, which is to the south and on the east side of the Eskay anticline. So, it's starting to look, I don't want to speak out of turn too much, but it's starting to look like we have a very prolific, extensive VMS field that basically encompasses a much, much larger area than any of us previously, speculated. So it's a very, right. Very exciting development.
And that's obviously why you're drilling, obviously, to try and see if you can prove that for sure. So is that basically the focus then for the next 3 months, is just to concentrate specifically on this drilling and then get results back?
Yeah, we've decided this year to really hit it hard and try to test a lot of new targets, really as many new targets as we can. We drilled at TVGF over the past couple of seasons, had great results last year. People can go back and look at the news over the past 12 months or so, we had fantastic results out of both TB and Jeff, but we decided to go ahead and test a lot more of these systems, or at least identify them, fully flush them out, and give them a first drill test this season. We've got drilling underway at Scarlet Ridge. I anticipate these other new targets that were discussed in this news release this morning will also be a subject of drilling. But we've got new areas too, like Excelsior, which is just to the west of TV Jeff. That looks like it could also be a very exciting discovery. It's very, very cool to see all of the drilling that we're doing, even on the extensions of TV Jeff. I mean, it's just, you know, it's going to be a year of growth for the company. And I think, you know, a lot of people have waited for us to find that big, you know, high grade part, like an Eskay Creek deposit. You know what, given the geologic similarities between the Scarlet Ridge area and Eskay Creek, we're very hopeful that something like that might turn up in the Scarlet Ridge region.
All right, Quinton. Well, thank you so much for the update. Appreciate it. Good luck with everything. And we'll continue to follow the story as the drilling continues and the results start to flow. So thanks very much.
Thank you, Steve.
All right. There's Dr. Quinton Hennigh. He is the technical advisor and director of Eskay Mining.